Hello children, welcome back to history class. In our previous video, we had discussed regarding the decline of the ancient Roman Empire and also about the impact of the barbarian invasions on the Roman Empire. Okay, so in today's class, we'll be continuing the chapter. We'll be discussing regarding the spread of Christianity and also about the Crusades or the Holy War. Next, we will discuss regarding the spread of Christianity. The spread of Christianity was one of the most important developments in the early medieval Europe. The Germanic tribes that overran Italy left the Church of Rome unharmed. Okay, so one of the important development that had taken place in the medieval Europe was the spread of Christianity. Okay, so the Germanic tribes that overran Italy, it didn't have its attack over the church in Rome. Okay, so the church was allowed to retain its spiritual power over all the Christians. In the 400 CE, most people in Europe were non-Christians. Okay, in 400 CE, there were no Christians in the European countries. Okay, so we can't see many number of Christians. Okay, however, within 500 years, by about 900 CE, most Europeans had been converted to Christianity. Okay, so within 500 years, the European countries became a Christian nations. In every European state, Christianity had become the state religion. Okay, so the entire state adopted Christianity, were converted to Christianity. Thus, the state religion became Christianity, or the Christianity became the state religion. The conversion of a king or a feudal lord was usually followed by a mass conversion of his subjects. Okay, so they slowly converted the king of a particular nation. So the entire citizens followed the king and they also been converted to Christianity. Okay, so as Christianity spread, the power and wealth of the church started multiplying. Okay, because the population to Christianity also increased. In the 11th century CE, the Muslim Turks invaded the land of the Christian emperor of Constantinople. Okay, so the Muslim Turks invaded the Christian lands. They had earlier captured Jerusalem, which was a part of the Holy Land of the Christians. Okay, so after capturing this Jerusalem, they started attacking the lands of the Christian Emperor Constantinople. So the Pope appealed to all Christians to join the Crusades, or we call it as a holy wars against the Turks to recover their holy land, to gain the holy land, okay, to rescue the holy land from the hands of the Muslim Turks. So between the 11th and 13th century, the Christians led 8 military expeditions against the Turks. Okay, so how many expeditions they have taken? It is 8 military expeditions. The Crusades failed to achieve their main objective, but they brought about several significant changes in the medieval Europe. Okay, we'll see what are they. In the course of their travels to the Holy Land, the Crusaders came in contact with the superior civilizations and cultures of the Greeks and the Turks. Okay, so the people, those who participated in the Crusades, in the war, okay, they came in contact with the Greeks and the Turks. They assimilated the best elements of these cultures. Okay, so they came to know about the good things about the cultures that were there in Greek and Turk, and started the process of the revival of Western education and learning, paving the way for the Renaissance. So thus
It led for the Renaissance. The second one is the Crusaders learned the use of gunpowder and guns from the Turks. Okay, so earlier they were not knowing about the gunpowder and the gun. They were used to it from the Turks. So these two discoveries contributed to the decline of the feudalism in the European nations. The armored knights had outlived their usefulness and their services were no longer required. Okay, so knights means it's soldiers. Okay, the Europe re-established direct trade contacts with other parts of the world. The Crusaders got a taste of the luxurious lifestyle of the East. So, to meet the demand for luxurious items, European traders began to establish trade links with the Eastern nations. So, as trade increased, the economy of Europe also started flourishing. The next point is regarding the establishment of the new towns and cities. The traders and manufacturers demanded the better conditions of law and order and a better system of law. So they paid the taxes to the king and helped him to raise a large army. So now the king had a large army under his control. So due to this, the authority of the king started increasing and the power of the feudal lords declined completely. Okay. We will stop here. The remaining will continue in our next video. Go through the video carefully. If you have any doubt, you can ask.